You stated that the greatest drug problem we're facing today is in women over 35. We've gone through the problems, but what are the solutions as you see them in traveling around the country and talking to so many women in that age bracket?
Well, there are many solutions. One, of course, is for women to be more satisfied with not a very exciting life. People have gotten such anticipatory desires in this country to live a life of just constant pleasure and excitement that when things are dull, which they're bound to be, they turn to something that's going to make it exciting. Or when women know that their children are going to leave the family, either to go to school or to get married, they have got to fill their life with some other kind of a high. Mm-hmm. In all of my drug work, I have learned not to preach against drugs, but to preach alternatively for other highs. Your church, your music, new hobbies, going back to school, more fun with your husband, camping trips, philosophy, anything that does the positive.
Right. You stress positive thinking and you speak on the subject a great deal. Is Norman Vincent Peale one of your inspirations in this area?
Yes, he is. He was very important to me when my daughter Diane died, calling me to urge me to speak on drug abuse. Mm-hmm. He's also a very dear old friend, and I'm just amazed at his positive thinking. And almost 80, and he's going like a steam engine all over the country.
Right. I think any of us that are familiar with your fabulous career have been always impressed with your eternal optimism, and even when you had that crisis in your own personal life, your optimism did come to your rescue. And do you have any guidelines to give us on how more of us can be more optimistic?
Well, of course, I think to be optimistic, you have to feel satisfied basically with what you are. You have to have a good self-image and not be constantly plaguing yourself with what you might be or could have been. Or should have been. For instance, it doesn't bother me at all to know that I cannot run like O.J. Simpson. He has different kind of legs than I have. And I can't think like Einstein. Mm-hmm. But what I do, I'm satisfied with, and I'm trying to make it better, but I live within my own abilities. And my philosophy is really that things turn out best for the people who make the best of the way things turn out.
Uh-huh. Now, Art, we were really impressed to learn about your very rigid religious upbringing. When you were a child, you weren't permitted to dance, you weren't permitted to go to shows, and then you rebelled against this religious upbringing. What about your religious attitude since that time? Are you still a religious person?
I'm very religious today. I speak in churches and I meet with young people, especially having seen the important role that religion plays in rehabilitating children in drug abuse or anybody, and also in preventing it. Mm-hmm. A great many people get into and stay into drug abuse because they have nobody to turn to, and if they have faith in God and belief in Jesus, they have somebody they can turn to. And during their dark moments, unlike an AA member, they don't have to dial somebody and find out if he's there to give them help.
Do you think religion has played an important part in your success in your life?
I think unwittingly it did. It didn't at the moment consciously, but I just think having a faith and a belief that came out of my early life got me over some pretty tough spots in the early part of my career. Mm-hmm. I had it pretty good for a lot of years, and when you have things good, you don't tend to look for any spiritual advice or give anybody else credit. We're only human.
You've written a number of bestsellers, and one of them is Women Are My Favorite People, and I wondered of all the women in show business, which one is your favorite?
In show business? Mm-hmm. Well, the people that I know best in show business were people like Dinah Shore, who is just a marvelous gal in every way, and people like Mary Tyler Moore, whom I like very much.
Mm-hmm. How about world figures? I know that you've spoken a lot about Eleanor
Roosevelt. I spoke about Eleanor Roosevelt and Madame Nehru, whom I like very much. And well, I must say that one of my dearest friends in show business is Greer Garson.
Uh-huh. And she was superb on Little Women. I don't know if you saw that recently.
Yes,
TV
I saw
special.
It. I talked to her the night it was on. She said, now you be sure to be looking. She has a ranch in New Mexico, uh-huh, right, where I visit her, and we go out riding together, and she's just a beautiful lady.
Kids have helped make you very famous, Art. And I know it's probably difficult with the millions of kids that have responded to you and followed you and you've talked to, but do you have a favorite kid that's dear and near to your heart in your work?
Well, in my work, no. I had several along the line that were important, that became movie stars and things like that. But most of the kids I see and know are come to my attention briefly and then move on. Mm-hmm. My own children, forward living children and seven grandchildren are the nearest and dearest to me. They're lovely kids.
I would say next to Muhammad Ali that Art Linkletter is one of the most recognizable persons in the world, and you do travel literally all over the world. And yeah. I wish you'd repeat for us the statement about what people say to you when they see you in person, and you know, when you were on the air, and how you look so much better alive than on TV.
Oh yes, people do say, they say you look better alive than you do on television. Or they may say, didn't you used to be Art Linkletter?
Probably in your career, which spanned over 40 years in radio and television, you were considered the number one conversationalist and the forerunner of all the talk shows we know today. What do you think are the key things in being a good conversationalist?
Be genuinely interested in the person, listen to him intently, and answer and participate. Because if you can't participate, it's just a one-way conversation. You have to add as well as question. But listening is most important.
It's been a joy to once again visit with Art Linkletter, who today is as vigorous and active as he ever was when he first started out in broadcasting 40 years ago. Thank you, Art.
Thank you.
That was world that the base